Boston over the summer. Boston Celtics rookie Jayson Tatum was cooking his teammates in the mid-range. All the scoring from the No. 3 overall pick could have been cause for celebration, but Tatum received some teaching instead. The 19-year-old has all the moves, step-backs, turnarounds, spin moves to either side. He can use his skill and athleticism to beat a defender, his length and high release to get off reasonable shots in tight spaces. Nobody who watched him at Duke or even in high school should be surprised his ability to create decent looks carried over to the NBA level immediately. We would play pickup games in September, remembered Celtics teammate Al Horford. And he was just abusing people in the mid-range. Just post the ball, shake and raise, and do all that. Horford was obviously impressed by Tatum's repertoire of moves. But upon seeing the way Tatum was playing, the way some scouts feared he might always play, head coach Brad Stevens let the rookie know he couldn't rock like that anymore. See, the Celtics didn't want Tatum to create decent looks. They wanted him to hunt great ones. No, Stevens said, according to Horford. We want you to get out there and shoot the 3s. Save those difficult mid-range attempts for end-of-the-clock type shots. It feels unbelievable now that Tatum's three-point shooting was considered a question mark during the pre-draft process. But he put a lot of work into that skill, the Celtics helped foster it, and Tatum has spent the first 2 months of his NBA career drop-kicking any doubts about his jumper. Incredibly, he currently leads the NBA with a 51.3% mark from behind the arc. When the Milwaukee Bucks sent hard double teams Monday night at Celtics star Kyrie Irving, Tatum punished them by drilling his first 4 three-pointers on the weak side en route to a home 17-point night. That was kind of one of the knocks on my game, that I couldn't shoot the tray real well, Tatum said. So I worked on it in the pre-draft process, and I continue to work on it. And I'm getting a lot of open shots, especially playing with these guys. The focus is on Kyrie, and guys help. They make the extra pass, and I knock them down. I worked on that day in and day out, added Tatum. I was trying to get drafted as high as possible. Worked on the things that teams said I couldn't do well, and shooting the three was one of them. By the time Tatum worked out for the Celtics this summer, Stevens said it was clear the rookie could already pump in shots from deep. Reflecting on Tatum's workout, the coach remembered the prospect looked effortless while directing the ball through the hoop. It didn't look like it was just one of those days where he was hitting everything, Stevens said. He would miss two in a row and it wouldn't dissuade him from hitting the next one. He had no thought about making the next five. He didn't get rattled. He just kind of kept shooting it. There were still concerns with Tatum's shot selection, which troubled a number of analysts this summer. Draft Express Mike Schmidt suggested Tatum's sometimes inefficient style and old man game aren't for everyone. One scout said to Bleacher Report's Jonathan Wasserman, when those shots two-point jumpers are going in, it certainly looks great. But there is so little margin for error for a player who will have one of the more difficult mixes of shot attempts in the league. Looking back, it's remarkable how outdated the criticisms already look. Tatum's shot profile has been elite. 41% of his shot attempts have come from inside the restricted area. Another 33.4% of his shot attempts have come from behind the arc. A lot of people thought he would live in the mid-range, but he has only taken 36 shots from that distance all, according to acunba.com, sometimes inefficient style. Of all players averaging at least 20 minutes per game, Tatum ranks 14th in true shooting percentage, a statistic that measures scoring efficiency. It's crazy. Bonkers. Insane. Still 19. Tatum recently finished a freshman at Duke where he shot a completely mediocre 34.2% from behind the arc. That sh don't matter, man, said Irving, dismissing the college stats. Jayson played the 34 at Duke so he was picking and popping, explained Irving. I don't think Jayson really picked and popped in the ways Coach K was utilizing him at Duke. Now he gets to come in and play his natural role and be in position to where he can not only be a threat from the three-point line but also a threat going to the rim. As Irving went on to suggest, it has helped Tatum that defenses need to spend so much of their energy trying to stop Irving and Horford. Watch how open the Bucks leave the rookie, who, again, currently tops the NBA in three-point shooting percentage. Pick.twitter.com's 1WVW3.4 hoops at Herald Celtics December 5, 2017. But Tatum deserves most of the credit for his rapid transformation. The coaching staff encouraged him to extend his range and the stars regularly free him for open shots, but it's Tatum who has knocked down more than half of his long balls. Horford needed years as an NBA veteran to extend his range. He knows how much time the process can take. I think Jayson has quickly understood finding his shots on the court and taken really good shots. If he doesn't have the shot, he's putting it down, he's creating, he's attacking the rim, Horford said. So it's impressive how quickly he's figured it out. Because it's not easy. But I just think he's doing a good job of really feeling the game out and shooting the ball with confidence. I've seen Jayson play since he was a sophomore in high school. I've been a fan of Jayson since then, added Irving. I think you worry about the transition from high school to college, and college to the NBA, but I think he's doing his due diligence in terms of putting the work in every day, doing what he needs to do and being a professional and learning how to consistently be that. It's just remarkable Tatum has learned so damn quickly. Stevens is already wondering what will come next, for a guy with his frame, he shoots it effortless, said the coach. I mean, he's going to be able to shoot it deeper, right? And he's going to be able to make it off running, once he gets a little bit stronger, more used to it, and everything else. He's going to be a heck of a shooter. He already is.